It's my responsibility as the judge of this county to represent 152,000 some white people to do everything within my power to exercise due diligence and to look for ways to be a good steward of what I've been entrusted with. I take that obligation very seriously. I take the people that are my colleagues very seriously, and I look at all of that. Sometimes it's not popular, and you know what? It could maybe get me unelected. But that's not what's important to me. What's important to me is doing the right thing, to look at the options that are in front of us, to explore even when it's a risky thing politically to do. And I'm willing to do that. And I'm asking everyone here, you can have your opinion, but do not take the commissioner's court to task for looking for ways to do the job that you say that you want them to do. You cannot speak out of both sides of your mouth and say that you want a conservative, ultra-conservative government that doesn't waste your dollars if you don't want that same government looking at the dollars that might be being wasted. It's wrong to not take a look at the unemployment claims or the workers' comp claims that are the liability side of operating a business and looking for ways to reduce them. If I told you that we can buy food much cheaper from this contract over here because they're offering us a better deal, the same conservatives that say be conservative would say, do that. You're supposed to be saving dollars if I try to buy it from Whole Foods instead of Walmart. We're looking for the best value at the best price. And that's not to discount people, but that's the job that's in front of us. Sheriff, you're going to need to weigh in on all of this because this confuses me. And I have I'm not sure which way we'll go today and what you'll want to authorize. I have never, you know, I'm glad to be able to say this to you directly, to you publicly, that I have never, ever tried to cut you out of this process. That is your jail, and I think you do a darn good job of running it. My hat has always been tipped to you and the staff that you have. I have walked in that jail, and it is nice. You know, for what it is, I mean, it's a jail. It is not supposed to be a luxury spa. And I think we all need to never forget that it's there for a purpose, not to, we want to acknowledge the inmates, their rights, and we should never deviate from doing what the right thing is and protecting those rights. But we can't forget that it also is a jail. It's yours, you do a great job with it. The funny thing is that I didn't even vote except to break a tie. So there's nothing in this for me to gain. If you walk up here today and you say, I don't want jail management, I'm not even voting on it. It's not going to be my thing. It's never been my thing. It's been my job to explore it. But I have no vested interest in it. And if you say that, Sheriff, you may as well come up, because I think we've got to explore the idea to move on. Because if ICE detainees is a way that you think that would draw a revenue stream, if we're looking at them, I have a concern. The concern is that the same groups that we've been evaluating their bids, if what is being said out there is true, that these are not reputable companies, that they should not be in our jail. I don't know how we can let them in our jail on the other side to manage detainees.
Because the federal government oversees that. But let me clear up one
thing. But you oversee the other, Sheriff.
I oversee the day-to-day operation of our end. The federal government has a person on location to oversee the ICE detainee. So if anything's wrong, they handle it. They have to be on location. But with Phil, is everybody's clear? I didn't just say it was a judge, I said the commission was 30. Okay, not just you. And I have not by running the county college, and it got carried away. Not here to argue those points, okay? I'm here to tell you that I have the best employees for a reason, okay? We may be shorthanded in the jail, but the employees have a say on who works in the jail. They're a part of the committee. They interview people when they come in for the job. And if they don't meet up to the expectations, they don't put a stamp of approval on it. We have one of the cleanest facilities in this state. Said so by one of the retired inspector. Sent me an email the other day telling me how we could pass any of the federal government upper echelon, their safety requisites for anything. We could be a part of all that. We were so clean. We had a gentleman come in today, saw his cleaning product, and was amazed that he wasn't getting any more dirt than he was with his genius idea of how he makes his cleaning product. So it's not about privatizing. I started this deal, and I'll tell everybody I started it. I wanted a house of highest attendance, not privatize my entire debt. That was my sole intent, to put some money back in the general fund. Had nothing to do with who did what. Just put some money back in the general fund to lower my housing for the inmates on the county side. That was it. Nothing more. I have not been a part of any of these for a reason. It was a conflict of my interest because I wanted to do my own investigation on different companies. Okay? And as far as the government side of it, ICE has somebody on location at every facility that oversees the ICE detainees and the people handled.
Would you not have someone on location in the jail? That would happen often with you?
I don't see the need to privatize a jail that is constantly working well and saving money and keeping prisoners safe, keeping the citizens safe. Mr. Huskins talked earlier about the assaults. Well, I can tell you right now, the assaults are way down in Ellis County Jail. They're way down from when he worked there. It was Western at one time. We still do have jail attacks every now and then.
We do, and we see it in our workers' comp claims.
The appropriate charges are filed, and you're going to have that with anybody.
Sheriff, let me ask you a question. If I understand right, you're still for jail management with ICE detainees.
Yes, I don't want to
know. And the RFP was for both sides so we could look at it.
The RFP that I saw that Dennis worked on and put a lot of different verbiage in it and added a lot of things to it was not the RFP he went out. A lot of the stuff he put in there was taken out. Okay. We're looking at the inmates and Bobby Cooper and his team. They go out and know everything in the county. They come out and help the commissioner from the county jail. They help cities. Okay. Where are we going to be at with that? Because that program will go away. I already pay out of my budget for lawnmowers, gas, everything. The county, I don't ask them for anything. I don't ask y'all to come.
Well, that comes from the county budget. Those might still be in your budget. Budget. Well, we put it in your budget. Or you just spend on behalf of the county.
I'm lost.
Okay.
You're telling me that if you still maintain your portion of the jail and you have ICE detainees over there in jail management, it's going to affect all Bobby Cooper and all these other people?
No, not if you privatize the entire jail.
No, I'm not talking about
no,
that.
I'm opposed to housing ICE detainees with a company because therefore, if a company's doing it, I don't have to hire a bunch of people that do that deal in 6 months or a year if the contract goes away.
And, you know, as a manager, in the previous world, I looked at the whole picture. I took the whole bottle of wax and added it out. And so I could understand where the profits were, where I could make management decisions to make it better. And by doing that, I mean, this RFP, we looked at both sides, and never have I said I'm for total jail management, or never I mean, I'm still trying to make that decision.
I am not for total jail management. I am for housing ICE